What is going on with the CDC, the conditional sale order, cruises out of Florida? There's been a lot that's changed just last week, and I've got all of it up next. Hey everyone, it's Matt from RailCaribbeanBlog.com, and today we're going to be talking about all the news that happened really at the end of last week related to Florida versus the CDC, and what impact it has, if any, on the cruise industry. Now, you may be aware that Florida sued the CDC back in April, and there's been an ongoing legal battle between Florida and the CDC. So, if you're not familiar, Florida sued the CDC in April. Then in June, a judge agreed with Florida and said, you know what? Florida is right. The CDC's rules it has for the cruise lines have overstepped the bounds of the CDC's authority. It's not fair. And as a result, the court ordered that the conditional sale order, the phased approach for cruise ships to return, should be more like recommendations than rules or requirements. And as a result, the judge said as of July 18th, his ruling would go into effect and the conditional sale order would be just a recommendation. All right, now let's fast forward. And the CDC appealed that decision. And the 11th Circuit Court of Appeals actually agreed with the CDC in the interim, saying we're going to offer a stay, which is a legal term meaning that the injunction, Florida's win, is going to be put on hold until the appeal can go forward. But then, 6 days later, this is going back now to just last week, that same court said, you know what? We're changing our minds on that, and actually we're not going to allow the stay to occur, and as of right now, the conditional sale order is now just a recommendation for ships that are sailing out of Florida. I should specify that the court's rulings only apply to Florida ports, so if they were talking about cruise ships going out of Washington State or Texas or New Jersey, the conditional sale order still applies. Now, why did the court change his mind? I'm really not sure. All they've said so far is that the CDC failed to, quote, demonstrate an entitlement to a stay pending appeal, end quote. So the result basically is right now, cruise ships do not have to follow the conditional sale order rules if they're sailing out of Florida ports. And that leads me talking into what exactly the conditional sale order is, because there's a lot of legal stuff going on here. Not everything, not all the rules we see on cruise ships apply to the CSO. So the conditional sale order was actually implemented, announced back in October 30th, 2020. And it was a four-phase conditional framework to allow the cruise industry to gradually resume operations if certain milestones were met. Phases of the CSO include securing agreements with the ports that a cruise ship sails from and how the port, health district, and cruise lines plan to respond in the event of a COVID case on board a cruise ship and the associated medical care, transportation, and housing if needed. Also required under the CSO are enhanced testing labs on cruise ships, simulated passenger cruises, which we've commonly referred to as test cruises, and various onboard and port-side safety procedures. Now, why did Florida sue the CDC? Well, Florida sued the CDC because they felt that these regulations, everything I just mentioned to you guys, was really onerous bureaucratic requirements that have been imposed on the cruise industry, like requiring proof of vaccine for passengers, and that test cruises would be needed at all. Now, without getting political at all about this, I think we can all objectively state that no other industry has had to have the CDC regulate their ability to restart operations during or after the pandemic. So from that standpoint, there is a point to be made there. But of course, there's obviously a lot of other things at play here. We're not going to get too much into that. But the bottom line is Florida felt that these laws were kind of cumbersome. And this is also coming at a time in which cruise lines had not gotten much, if any, progress out of the CDC. Since then, a lot has happened. The CDC has come back to the negotiating table, perhaps in part because of this lawsuit, with the cruise lines to try to get them back into service. And you've already heard on this channel all about different cruise ships that have restarted operations out of the United States and with more on the way. In fact, the judge on the case wanted to align the conditional sale order with other CDC guidelines for the reopening of other industries, just as airlines, casinos, hotels, sports venues, and subway. Essentially, recommendations, guidelines, not mandates by the agency. So now let's talk about what does this mean? Like, what is the fallout? What should we expect as cruise guests? What will change? And what's interesting, actually, is that not much may change at all going forward, at least not in the short term. A few hours after the news broke, Royal Caribbean International President and CEO Michael Bailey posted on social media that Royal Caribbean will not deviate from the CDC's regulations. Quote, "We will continue to voluntarily follow all CDC guidelines and recommendations," end quote. So essentially, it sounds like test cruises are going to continue out of Florida, and Royal Caribbean will continue to work with the CDC in order to ensure that there's approval, basically covering their bases that if the conditional sale order was reinstated during the appeals process, all of a sudden you don't have a bunch of ships that are back out of service because they're not approved by the CDC. And there's probably a lot of other reasons for that as well. I mean, they still have to work with the CDC in other places. It might be a little awkward. I don't know. I can't speculate on that standpoint. I'm just saying clearly they want to make it as simple as possible. And following or continuing to follow the CDC guidelines is probably in their best interest in the long run, especially with that relationship that they have with the federal agency. Now, there's one other thing you should be aware of as it relates to the fallout of the conditional sale order being lifted or making into a recommendation than a requirement, and that is the CDC said, while all those rules in the CSO that I outlined earlier in this video are now suggestions, there is one thing that will be staying, and that is the mask mandate. Right after the court changed its mind, the CDC said, by the way, it will still enforce its transit mask requirements on cruise ships in Florida that opt not to abide by the conditional sale order as a result of the court ruling. In February 2021, the CDC instituted an order that requires people to wear masks on public transportation, which includes things like aircraft, train, road vehicles, vessels, and other means of transportation. So essentially, the same rule that you have to wear a mask on an airplane is what's at play here, and it's not tied to the conditional sale order. They're independent of each other. Now, unlike airlines, the enforcement of this order is going to fall to the U.S. Coast Guard as opposed to the TSA, like you would see in an airport or something like that. And basically, the CDC said it will not relinquish mask requirements that it has for indoor spaces on cruise ships for those lines that are not voluntarily complying with the CSO. So if you're one of the many people hoping perhaps the mask requirements would be relaxed or removed altogether as a result of this change, doesn't appear so, because that rule comes from something outside of the conditional sale order. There's a lot here that's happening, and let's face it, probably another couple weeks or months from now, it's all going to change again, but it's part of the process, and I want to keep you guys up to date with what is happening in the cruise industry, because this is kind of a big deal right now. Let me know in the comments what you think about this, the court reversing its mind, the conditional sale order stuff, and of course, Royal Caribbean's decision to still follow these guidelines going forward. I always look forward to reading your comments down there below. If you like this video, hit that like button. Even if you don't agree with what happened, hitting the like button still supports Royal Caribbean Blog, this video channel, so that way other people get to see the video as well through YouTube's algorithm. And of course, if you enjoy and want to see more of this kind of content, make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on your notifications, so that way YouTube lets you know when I have a brand new video to share. This has been Matt from RoyalCaribbeanBlog.com, and we'll talk again real soon.